In this video, Ahmad is going to show you how you can calculate the conversion rate of two Google Analytics events inside of Beta Studio. All and more coming up.
This video is brought to you by our premium membership, Measure Masters. If you truly want to master the art of analytics and data, then become a member today and get access to over 70 hours of premium video content, exclusive tools, and mingle with other fellow Measure Masters in our community. And if you ever get stuck, I'm there for you to answer your questions and support you along the way to Measure Mastery. Join today and become a Measure Master.
Thanks, Julian. This is Ahmad again with another tutorial for Google Data Studio. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to calculate the conversion rate between two different events and report it using Google Data Studio. Let's start by creating a new report in Data Studio and connecting it to Google Analytics data for Google Merchandise Store. And now, let's first take a look at the events that are existing in this data set. So what I want to see is events category, events action, and events label. So these are my dimensions, and then for the metric I want to see the total number of events. Quick tip, you can double click on any of these edges to quickly adjust the width of these columns of any table in Google Data Studio. Let's view and take a look at what kind of events do we have. So most of them seem to be quick view clicks, but what I'm interested in for the purpose of this tutorial is enhanced e-commerce add to cart and enhanced e-commerce product click. Now when people come to this website, they click on products and then they might add them to the cart. Okay, what we want to calculate right now is the ratio between product add to cart and product clicks. So it is kind of product add to cart conversion rate, as to say. So let's go back to edit mode and see how can we define such kind of calculated metric in Google Data Studio. So normally when we have a metric here and we want to create a calculated metric, we can click on here on page views and create a field. Now we can name it anything we want, like product click to ATC for add to cart conversion rate. So from each 100 product clicks that we get, how many add to carts do we get? Now here we cannot use a normal formula, because in normal formula, for example, we can divide page views, okay, page views, okay, by the number of sessions, for example. We can do that. We can divide a metric by another metric. We can add a metric to another metric. Okay, we can do arithmetic calculations with any two metrics that we want, but we cannot do it with a subset of each metric. So the metric that we are looking at right now is total events. Okay, you can see we can put total events in here, but we cannot divide it by anything else. Like we cannot divide total events by total events. We cannot say that, okay, Google Data Studio, please divide just those events that match the event action add to cart by those events that match the event action of product click. We cannot say that directly in the formula. It is a single metric, and we cannot use subsets of a single metric in our calculations. We cannot say just some events divided by some other events. Okay, the total of some events divided by the total of some other events. We cannot say that directly. So what should we do? Let's see the trick that makes this happen. So first of all, what we need to do is to create a scorecard for our main metric, which is total events. Okay, so total events, we put it here, and we can see the total number of events. And if we add a summary row to this table, we can add we can see that the numbers match. So this is the number of total events that these Google Analytics accounts had in the time frame of this report. But how can we get the total number of events with event action product click? So how can we get this number? To do this, we need to add a filter to our scorecard. So let's go on and add a filter. I'm gonna call it, I usually call the name of a filter the exact criteria for that filter. So for example, for this one, I say event action equals product click. That way, when I'm looking at the list of filters in my Google Data Studio report at a future date, I can quickly see what is this filter doing. Okay, I just need to include event actions that are equal to product click, exactly as it appears here. Okay, so now it should filter this scorecard and show me the number of product clicks. Right now, it is not total events anymore. It is a filtered version of total events. That's why I need to click here and rename it to product clicks, because I'd like the title of the metric to be descriptive, to show what the metric is about. And this is how we do it. We can click here and change the name of the metric temporarily, not on the data source level, just for this scorecard, to whatever we want. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit Control C and Control V to copy and paste this scorecard and create another one. And for this one, I'm gonna apply another filter. So let's again click on add a filter and click a filter. And this time, guess what? Event action equals add to cart. Okay, this is the event action that I want. So let me copy this to save myself from typing it again. And we want to include event actions that are equal to add to cart. And now we should have this number, 7,373. Okay, now again, this is not product clicks. This is add to cart, or adds to cart. Let's keep it just like this. Okay, so I have the number of add to carts and I have the number of product clicks. These are basically the same metric. These are both total events, but these two scorecards have been filtered differently. So this is total events, one filter applied, this is total event, another filter applied. Now here's the trick. When you create your metrics and filter them in the way that you want, in you are already getting the numbers that you want, so the number of adds to cart and product clicks, you select both of those, right click, and click blend data, and a new scorecard appears. Okay, this is the new scorecard. Here's the difference. If you check any of these two scorecards, these are connected to Google Analytics, Google Merchandise Store as their data source. But this one, however, is connected to blended data. What is this blended data? This is a combination of two data sources. And in this case, is one data source is product clicks, total events filtered to show product clicks only. And the other data source is total events filtered to show add to cards only. And right here, you can see that we have only two available fields, product click and add to cart. If you click on the metric, only two metrics are available in this blended data source. Okay, now how to calculate the conversion rates between add to cart and product click, how to divide them together. You can click here on the metric. Only here you can click on create a field, name it. So it's usually in these cases I use this naming convention, CR for conversion rate between add to cart from between product click and add to cart. So conversion rate between product clicks and add to cart. It should be somewhere close to 65-70%, because it's 7,000 over close to 12,000. Okay, but here we don't have any metric named total events in this blended data set anymore. The only things that we have are adds to cart, and we can divide it by product clicks. Okay, and these are the names that we've given to these two metrics. This could be my name, this could be Julian's name, you know, put any name that you want on the metrics that you create, but you know, let's be clear and descriptive. Right now, if I divide these two metrics together, it will give me a number less than one. But that's why I need to choose here, instead of number, I want a percentage that converts that ratio to a percentage, and then I can click apply. Because it's a percentage, I tend to choose average, because if it's reported in a table, then you have the summary row available, it will add percentages together. For example, if you have all 1%, 1%, 1%, it will add them together to create a 3% summary row, which is not true. So I put average whenever I create a percentage metric or a conversion rate. Okay, so let's click apply, see what do we have. Okay, so conversion rate between product click and add to cart is 61%. This is conversion rate between a subset of events, those who match our filter here, the way we created, and the other subset of events. You can use this same technique to blend and combine up to 5 different metrics of this type together. In other words, any blended data source can have up to 5 different data sources blended together in itself. Okay. Now this creates a whole lot of possibilities for you. So for example, let's say we also have events for product impression, product checkouts, product removes from cart, and product purchases. So impression, click, add to cart, checkout, and purchase, 5 different metrics. Okay, and if we have all these 5 metrics together in a single blended data, then we can divide them together and come up with calculated metrics like product CTR or click-through rate, which would be the number of click divided by the number of impressions. Or we can have the checkout conversion rate, which is the number of purchases divided by the number of checkouts. Or maybe even checkout abandonment, which is 1 minus the ratio between product purchases and product checkouts. So the sky is the limit, and then you are not limited to events at all. So it is not that we can only do this with events. We can do the same technique. We can apply it to page views of the certain page titles or page URLs. We can apply it to sessions. Any metric in Google Analytics and in your data source that you can filter and create a subset of, you can combine them together, select them all, right click, and blend them together, and use the blended data source to create custom calculated metrics. You can also use the same technique on page views and, for example, divide the number of page views of your cart page by the number of page views of your product page and category page and home page. Or if you have a funnel from the landing page to the order page to the thank you page, you can have 3 different metrics of page views to these pages, blend them together, and calculate the conversion rate between each step to the next step. Now that you learned this technique, it's your turn to put it to use.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can calculate the conversion rate between 2 Google Analytics events within Data Studio. Did you know about this technique beforehand? I actually didn't know. I always used another trick, but which was a little bit more complicated. So thank you, Ahmad, for making this video for us. Definitely, well, appreciate it. If you like this video, then please leave us a comment down below how you found it and give us a thumbs up. And also, if you haven't yet, maybe consider subscribing to our channel right over there, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian, and on behalf of Ahmad, till next time.